So the energy balance for tubular reactor, we'll use a similar approach to that for a stirred tank reactor, except now we're just looking at steady state. We'll later look at unsteady state, but the unsteady state becomes a partial differential equation. We'll look at the simple A goes to B reaction, constant heat capacities. We're doing a differential energy balance, meaning we're picking some differential volume and we're looking at the changes. So if I start writing down the terms, since it's steady state, the accumulation is zero. The energy flow in would be the flow rate of A, that's a molar flow rate. Enthalpy of A evaluated at the temperature, right? The temperature right here at the inlet to that differential volume. And the same term for B flowing into differential volume. And then flow out FA will have changed by some differential amount. Likewise, HA will have changed by some differential amount. And I'll just write it that way. And similar term for B. Enthalpy of B evaluated the inlet temperature and then some differential change in enthalpy of B. The only other term is a term due to the heat transfer across the wall. So this is differential area. This is heat transfer per time. So what we're going to do is simplify this equation. We're going to dividing by that differential volume, and then we're taking a limit as the differential volume goes to zero. So we're taking this limit the same way we do normally, and what we're going to do is just look at the terms. So you'll notice that we have flow rate of A, enthalpy of A, and then here we have flow rate of A times enthalpy of A with a minus sign. That terms are going to cancel, likewise for B. And so what we end up with then is the remaining terms. So if we look at this term, eliminates that one term. This term is also going to be canceled by this term. So we have minus the flow rate of A times the HA. And then we have dFA dHA. Oops, and that's also minus FB dHB. And likewise, this second order term, dFB dHB. Remember, this is all equal to zero dQ dot. Other terms that I left out, since we have in this term here, we have four terms. One term subtracts out with the circle term. We've written down a couple of terms, so what we still need is minus dFA times HA, and likewise minus dFB times HB. Let's be consistent, it's evaluated at the temperature T. So now we're ready to actually do the division by dV, and so a couple of things to note. We divide by dV, we would have the flow rate of A, dHA. The second term, we'd have a differential multiplied by derivative, so as that differentials go to zero, likewise for this other second order term. So we know, simplifying quite a bit, the third term, and then HA evaluated T, the derivative of FA respect to V minus HB evaluated T. These are the last two terms in the equation, dFB dV plus dQ dot dV. So the the first term, let's look at the first term, the derivative of HA respect to V. So look at the derivative of HA, differential respect to V. What we're going to do is say, well, that's the derivative respect to temperature, multiply by the derivative of temperature, derivative of HA respect to temperature, derivative of temperature respect to V. And we've seen before that the reason enthalpy changes with temperature when there's no phase change for a single component, heat capacity of A. That's our definition of heat capacity, is the derivative of H respect to T. So we'll have terms like that for A and B that we can substitute back into the equation. We can also make the substitution for the derivative of FA respect to B. So the derivative of FA respect to V, we know from our mass balance, is R sub A. Similar derivative FB respect to V, right? The derivative FB respect to V is RB, which is minus RA. So if we make those substitutions and do some rearrangements, then we end up with that zero is minus the flow rate of A times the heat capacity of A. And let me combine these terms, flow rate of B, heat capacity of B, times the derivative of temperature respect to volume. What this means, of course, is how is the temperature changing as we're moving down the reactor? So beginning the reactor, volume equals zero. The temperature changes as the cube volume down the reactor. And then we'll have, again, by rearranging, we'll have HB evaluated at T minus HA evaluated at T multiplied by that rate of reaction and the dQ dot for heat transfer is equal to zero. So left out of the parentheses here. So this term is the heat of reaction, right? Enthalpy of products minus enthalpy of reactants. And it's the heat of reaction evaluated at temperature T, since that's the enthalpies that we're using in the calculation. Okay, so we're almost finished, because we didn't need this other equal zero here. Let's rearrange and bring some things to the left side of the equation. The flow rate of A, heat capacity of A, plus the flow rate of B, heat capacity of B, times the derivative of temperature as we move down the reactor is equal to the heat of reaction, temperature in that differential volume, the rate of reaction, which of course is a function of location in the reactor, and dQ dot dV. So this is the equation that we'll want to apply then to a plug flow reactor, a tubular reactor, steady state for a simple reaction, and we would solve this simultaneously with the energy balance. Now notice we assume that CPA and CPB are constant, but turns out it's the same equation when CPA, CPB depend on temperature. Okay, so there's a couple things that we can look at to clarify. The first thing we want to do is look at the dQ dV term and explain what that looks like. So dQ dot term would be some heat transfer coefficient times the differential area times the temperature on the outside, some cooling temperature, minus the temperature in the reactor. So remember, this is the heat transfer for just a differential volume. We're looking at some small volume transfer through the walls, we have some differential area. We could write that in terms of pi times the diameter of the tube times dz, so z is distance down the reactor, of course tc minus t. If we now divide by dv, since that's the form that appears in the energy balance, and so dv would be area, cross-section area times the distance. That would be our differential volume. If we do that division, dq dot dv, and just organize the page a little here. So 4 times the heat transfer coefficient divided by the diameter Tc minus T. So that's the term that we're going to put into the energy balance term above.